sauce, but
the only one I really don't like is Red Cheek for some reason. It's just like a weird red because it's kind of pinkish, but not pink at all. Tastes good. I like the green and yellow stock.
Yeah.
These are nice matchups. It's so easy for Fox, relatively. Just, all you gotta do is get a shine, and it leads into so much. You can choose, like, any of, like, five options, which are equally good.
Yeah, that was super smart of Lucky to fade back there so he didn't get hit by the needle. I feel like if he had done the horizontal needle first, it would have gotten him.
Yeah, I mean, as a scrubby sheep, that's just what I do.
That was a crazy fucking angle from Lucky. Did you see that?
I mean,
oh, that's like the Tenchi, though. What he does is he, only Sheik I play does this, is he switches to Zelda for, like, the slower float speed, but then
drift.
He always switches back before he gets to ledge.
Yeah,
he, like,
Shroom
goes
does
low
that too
and
a lot,
then
I've seen.
It's really good. Obviously didn't work there, because he was just a little too far, but it really trips people up when they just expect, like, the Zelda to teleport to stage. There you go, that's what he was looking for earlier. I would have totally gone for, like, the drop-down fair, missed it, and let Lucky live. It's the classic Tekken play shine.
Yeah, at that point you just gotta... You're kind of just reading whether they're gonna Tekken play shine or do anything else.
Yeah,
everything else is super reactable.
Yeah, Tekken play shine is like... Even when you read it, you often fuck up and get hit by it, though.
Yeah, it's really... It's even a tough window when you read it.
That's really good.
But you can read it by doing a like a early up tilt or a charged up smash or a down smash depending on DI, and that makes it a little easier to hit on a read. But on the re-grab is pretty much always hard.
Yeah. Although I guess the good thing is if you hit that up tilt, you can still get a shit ton of percent machine.
Yeah.
Even if it's not the zero down. Okay, Tenchi's up. Let's go. It's my boy.
All the needles. Yeah.
Okay,
really
so last stop. This is like where the commentators always say, oh, Lucky's gonna better player him now. But it's so true, right?
I mean, yeah, I get better played all the time in last
stop. Yeah,
stock.
Same. It's like the coolest thing in Melee.
Oh, you see, that was good smashy on that drill.
Yeah,
the drill would have killed him.
Oh, shit.
I wonder if he got out of that by SDing this time. Ooh, it's got a grab ledge there.
It's crazy, because this is so close, but it just, yeah, it feels like Lucky has all the momentum.
Yeah. Yeah, he was kind of messing around with it at the very end when he could have just up throw up right after done like less wave shines.
Yeah,
I forget what the percent was.
He got a flex, you know.
Wave shining is real fun.
Oh shit, he's going Falco. I'm not sure if this is a good decision for Lucky. It was pretty close with his Fox.
Could be a playstyle counter though.
Yeah. Have you seen Lucky's Falco before?
No,
like,
never.
I know his Falcon and his Fox,
yeah,
but I haven't really seen his Falco. I'm sure it's sick.
Yeah, the biggest thing with this switch is just, like, getting the wave dashes down, but it's not too hard to, like, be switching between the two as long as you're not missing wave dashes.
Really? Because I've always heard that, I guess maybe the wave dash is really hard.
I mean, it's just like a big thing with like switching characters for the most part.
Yeah, I mean, you switch between the two, or at least used to every now and then, right?
Yeah.
Because you would use Falco for Spaceys, I remember.
Yeah, and switching characters like obviously affects the other person too. Like some people will switch to a heavier character to make your throws take longer.
Yeah.
Which is an interesting strategy. Because then you don't start acting out of them.
That happens to me for sure.
Oh, yeah, because of handoffs.
Yeah. Oh, especially with handoffs. But no, dude, I'm a quintessential wobbler now. I don't do handoffs.
That's actually so good against Sheik. Just like, miss tech is like really underrated, I think, when you're getting tech chased.
And then do you just wait and react after the miss tech? Because.
And then you kind of just pick an option where like regular get up's good, but a perfect Sheik will just jab reset you.
Yeah.
Unless you're super high percent.
Unless you like buffer get up attack or whatever.
Are we gonna get up shine?
So Tenchi's doing that like fake recovery like right to next to the ledge like
yeah.
So much. It's working for him though, so
yeah, he shortened a couple earlier I think too.
Yeah, no, he's definitely has, like, the shortens on it. It's hard for me to tell when a Sheik shortens, though.
Yeah, I mean, shorten is literally just what turns what should be an automatic edge guard into somewhat of a read.
Yeah.
If, like, a Sheik can't shorten, then...
Oh, it's super free.
Yeah, then you just react to everything.
Ooh.
Damn, what? I've never seen that connect.
How many of those inputs do you think were intentional? Down tilt, full hop, forward air,
re-grab. Down
tilt was
definitely intentional.
Down tilt was, yeah.
And
probably
re-grab
the re-grab.
Was intentional,
yeah.
And I'm pretty sure the forward air was just too perfect. Yeah, that's like the fastest way you can grab ledge. So spacey is run up, shine, turn around, wave dash.
Crazy spot dodges. I wonder if
I'm surprised you got that back air.
Oh shit.
That was really fast. That's always rough.
That's not safe.
Less so.
Heck yeah, that should be it. That was... I should do that. I never thought to like just grab ledge out of the down air.
Yeah, that's like, really all you can do. That guarantees you'll be safe. But then you're on ledge.
Heck yeah, this could be over. Fucked up the dash back, but got it. Oh, are they calling us for,
Yeah, I think we gotta head out. PM side
okay.
Bracket start.
Sorry to leave y'all without commentary, but we gotta play. Peace.
Two.
Two.